Patient referrals we're going to talk about first. What is the worst complaint you can have in your practice?
I'm going to put you on the spot.
What's the worst complaint you can think about? Say it again. Feeling pressure? Okay. Anything else?
The office is dirty.
Dirty? Yeah, that'd be a bad one. Yeah.
You don't want to show off a sterilization room.
Anything else?
Terrible service.
So it's a little bit of a trick question. The worst complaint you'll ever receive, regardless of your business, is one you never know about. That's the worst complaint. But meanwhile, that person goes out and tells 20 people in the community. That's the worst complaint. So how do you help ensure that doesn't happen in your practice? Well, one is making sure everything's in order, sterilization's clean, things like that. But the other is training every single team member. And again, it goes back to the strategy and culture of your operation to want to ask every patient how their experience was today. How did everything go? Every team member that comes in contact with a patient in your office every day needs to ask that question. They can do it in their own way, but it needs to be asked. One, it shows the patient you care. I can pretty much guarantee you, if that patient goes in a second opinion, every team member is not going to ask them, hey, did everything go good today? How was your experience? Etc. Another way to separate yourself commercially from everybody else. But what it also does is two things. Let's say the response is, it was great. It opens up the floor, which is the number one way to increase your patient referrals, is by asking for them. You have to ask, otherwise you will not get them at the level you otherwise could. So if they respond back with, it went great, the response back needs to be fantastic. We worked hard at that. We would love for you to send us your friends and family. You know how happy you are with your Invisalign case. Send us your friends and family, your coworkers. It opens up a perfect asking for referrals is awkward. I don't think anyone wakes up in the morning going, I'm excited to do it. It can be awkward. So you want to open up opportunities for yourself where it is not awkward. And by doing that, you also accomplish great customer service because you're asking your clientele, in this case your patients, how did everything go today? Now what it also does is accomplish what the worst complaint you could possibly have. Because if that response is negative, then that didn't go so well. I waited too long. Whatever the response is, it's negative. That gives you an opportunity to overcome it and fix the problem now, as opposed to them leaving, writing a negative review, or telling 20 people in the community or where they work that, hey, look, Dr. So-and-so down the street, hey, I waited 20 minutes past my appointment time, sterilization was dirty, whatever it may be. You need to find out that information because consumers talk. So you have to give them a platform to talk to you instead of everybody else. Now, you want them to talk to everybody else about referrals and other things. But the worst complaint you can receive as a business is the ones that you don't know about. Hundreds of people think your business stinks, but you don't know. If you know, you can fix it. So train your staff, doctors as well. How's everything going today? Is my staff treating you great? Is the experience wonderful? Yes, it is. We're happy. We want you to send you more people just like you. They're not going to get annoyed if you ask. A friend of mine, he's turned into one of my very good friends. They have a practice in Houston. And he lives next door to the same guys that I've lived next door for years. And this guy next door knows he owns a dental practice. And one day they're talking, having some cocktails, and Stephen goes to his neighbor, how come you've never been a patient at my practice? What do you think the patient, or what do you think he said, his neighbor? You never asked me to. You've got to ask. You can't just expect that they're going to do it. You have to ask them. And based on effective frequency, you have to ask them over and over and over again. Consumers need to hear a message upwards of 20 times before they're likely to make a decision at a high level. Buying decision, referring decision, upwards of 20 times. We try, we're not telling you to ask 20 times when they're in your practice, by the way, so don't misunderstand that. But just get the point, because at minimum, every one of you in here, me, Eric, all of you, you need to hear a message a minimum of 4 times to get you to buy at a high level. You may not realize it, but again, based on biology, factual data, whether it's an insurance company doing it, an orthodontic commercial, whatever, you need to hear that message a minimum of 4 times to at least act at a relatively decent level. So the more times you can ask these things with patient referrals, the better. but also allows you to overcome a situation where they may tell 20 people, but not you.